Do you often struggle with percentages and resizing your soap recipes? Well, this video will have you recalculating like a pro. So let's jump right in. Hypothetically, your oil blend recipe consists of 10 ounces of coconut, 15 ounces of palm, and 25 ounces of olive. It's pretty simple when the recipe is given. But what if you wanted to change one of the oils? Well, you would need to know the percentages. So what is the percentage of each oil in this blend? Step 1. We first add to get the total oil blend. Easy enough. 50 ounces. Step 2. We divide each oil by the total of 50. Step 3. 10 ounces of coconut is 20%. 15 ounces of palm is 30%. And 25 ounces of olive is 50%. Fairly simple math, right? So why would you need to know this? Because it makes increasing or decreasing while keeping your master recipe exact. Say you had a mold that only held 20 ounces of oils. We can easily calculate the recipe based on the percentage. All we need to do is multiply the percentage by the new oil blend size of 20. And this can be done the exact same way for increasing your oil blend. Of course, with any change in your soap recipe, be sure to rerun it through the lye calculator to determine the correct lye amount. Let's use a reliable recipe and scale it to fit a new mold. If you need to know how to determine your mold size, pause this video and review our Soapmaking Molds video here. This is the basic tried and true Bastille recipe that we use for nearly all of our soap making videos. It is formulated to fit a 3-pound mold and is super fatted at 5%. It consists of 2 ounces of castor oil, 8 ounces of coconut oil, and 22 ounces of olive oil, making for a 32-ounce oil blend. Let's say our new mold size holds 56.2 ounces of oil. How will we resize the recipe to make it fit? Step 1. We first need to determine what percentage each oil is in our recipe. As we did before, we divide each oil by the total base amount. Step 2. We then take our percentage and multiply each by the new oil blend total of 56.2. And there you have it. Our recipe is now resized for our new mold. All that is left to do is to calculate our lye and water amount. But that's for another video. For now, we can just run it through an online lye calculator. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section below, and I'll do my best to answer. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see y'all next time.